everybody. So I am American, you can probably tell from my accent, and I just spent a semester at a Scottish university. And there's a couple videos I want to make about that, but this first one, I want to talk about the differences between the American system of measurement and the metric system. One of the reasons I picked this in particular is because I met some people here who are planning to study abroad in the United States. And talking to them, I found out that I know a lot more about the metric system than they know about the imperial system. So I'm making this video to help out anyone who knows the metric system and who's planning to visit the US. So here goes. First off, we have distance. This is 1 foot. It is also 12 inches. It is also 30.48 centimeters. So this is what Americans use to measure most distances. When it comes to smaller distances, people on the metric system use millimeters, but in America, on a ruler that's not made from cardboard, you'll be able to see little dots in between the inches. That'll be half inch, quarter inch, eighth inch, 16th inch. Those are how we measure like tiny, precise distances. When it comes to distances that are a little longer, 3 feet make up 1 yard, which is just a little more than a meter. In fact, you can see up there, 1 yard equals 91.4 centimeters. If you want to get further distances than that, you use kilometers, but Americans use miles. So 1 mile equals 1.61 kilometers. As Google will generously show, a mile is also 5,280 feet. But you don't really need to know that number. Most Americans don't know it anyway. Most Americans have a pretty good idea of what those metric measurements are because we learn it in science class. From middle school onward, all my science teachers were really strict about when we're in science class, we use the metric system. We don't use inches, we use centimeters. Also, on any ruler that is not hand-drawn on a piece of cardboard, there will be inches on the one side and centimeters on the other side, on the top. So you can flip it around, get centimeters, and then flip it around, get inches, whichever measurement you need. Another thing on Google Maps, it always has a scale. I don't know if it's like this in other countries, but in America, there's always the scale that so many kilometers equals so many miles, like in the bottom corner. And also on our car speedometers, there will be miles, and then really tiny on the inner circle, it'll say so many kilometers per hour. And on the pedometer as well, there's miles, and then smaller under it, there's kilometers. Anyway, on to temperature. Americans use the Fahrenheit scale for most temperatures, which in my opinion is better for measuring weather, and Celsius is better for measuring most other things. However, these two scales can be a little confusing because if you look at the conversion formula up there, and you haven't had algebra in a while, that can be a little intimidating. I don't expect anyone to memorize that formula and be able to do it in their head, so I have a shortcut for you that I learned from being in a place that uses Celsius. I did not memorize the conversion formula, I just memorized these two numbers. Freezing point, 0 degrees Celsius and 32 degrees Fahrenheit, and the human body temperature, 37 degrees Celsius and 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. Most weather that you will come across will be between those two numbers, and just knowing those two numbers, it will be a lot easier to kind of guess what's in the middle. So for instance, if I hear 20 degrees Celsius, I'm gonna guess that's close to 65 degrees Fahrenheit. 68, I was close, so there's my point. You get better at guessing that just with practice. Next up is volume. Now, most Americans know liters really well because a lot of our volume measurements are in liters. For example, soda, it's pretty normal to see them sold in 2-liter bottles like this. A lot of gas stations in my area, either Coke or Pepsi, will usually have a 2-for-3 deal on them. Also, most of our wine, most of our alcohol, with the exception of beer, is sold in liters. A lot of our drinks also come in ounces, which we don't deal with it too very often, but we at least have some idea what an ounce is. For context, a normal can of soda, normal size can of soda, in America, it's 12 ounces. I just looked up the official conversion rate is 1 ounce equals 28.4 milliliters. Also, to make it a little bit more confusing, ounces aren't the only measurement we use. A much more familiar measurement is gallons, which the conversion rate there is 1 gallon is 3.6 liters. So things we buy in gallons, most common are milk and gasoline, petrol. Now, to be completely confusing, we also have different units of measurement for cooking. 1 teaspoon is 4.9 milliliters, and 1 tablespoon is 14.8 milliliters. But unless you read an American cookbook, you probably won't see those. Now, over to the last thing, which is weight. The most common thing Americans use are pounds and ounces. You can see the conversion rate up there. 1 pound is 0.45 kilograms, and 1 ounce is 28.3 grams. Also, if you want to reverse convert, 1 kilogram is 2.2 pounds. You may have also heard of a measurement ton. Well, Americans have that too. 1 American ton is 2,000 pounds. It is also slightly less than 1 metric ton. So, in case you want to lift anything really heavy. That's it for now, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos and like and comment. Stay cool.